Joining us today, Senator Ping Lacson. Senator, good morning.
Good morning, Pinky.
So many things I wanted to discuss with you first, sir. Before I forget, I'll go to the older ones. Gun control. I understand through, my readings, when you were chief of the PNP, but this is quite, I think I read this about a week ago, you only issued, if I'm not mistaken, sir, about 600 permit to carries during your time as chief PNP.
That is correct. Mm. Because my policy direction at the time was to eventually not issue permits to carry firearms or outside residence. Because in my belief, or in my opinion at least, people should not be carrying firearms outside the residence because firearms are supposed to be used for their personal defense, for the protection of their properties. Mm-hmm. Now, carrying of firearms has become so blatant that people get to used to see people carrying firearms. And if they see people or a person carrying firearms, the assumption outright is that he is a law enforcement agent or he has a permit to carry firearm outside residence.
Mm-hmm. So 600 PTCs, permit to carries, and there was a funny, you know, an interesting story there. Mm-hmm. Way back when you were chief PNP, I think it was the husband of Senator Miriam Defensor Santiago who went to you.
Who was the undersecretary of DILG at that time.
At that time, mm-hmm. And said that the senator wanted, I think, a PTC, a permit to carry her firearm. And you told the USEC June Santiago that time, napapuntahin si Senator Miriam Defensor Santiago sa PNP to actually do the written exam. And to conclude that, she actually helped in modifying or fixing the English doon sa exam ninyo. Totoo ba yun?
That is correct. When June Santiago or USEC Santiago at the time asked me to issue a permit to carry to his wife, ano, then Senator Miriam Defensor Santiago, ang sabi ko sa kanya, USEC, wala pong problema. Papuntahin lang po ninyo sa KRAME at mag-undergo ng lahat ng mga requirements. Mag-undertake ng exam, kumuha ng psychiatric test, tapos gun safety seminar, and so forth and so on. So sabi niya, eh, magagalit sa akin yun. Sabi ko, wala po tayong magagawa kasi isa lang ang standard. Once I apply a double standard, then that's the end of the policy. You know? Marami ng hingin na exemption.
And she did it.
She did it. Uh-huh. And as a matter of fact, she corrected and improved the written examination kasi
that's
maraming
right.
May mga mali-mali doon, siguro grammatical errors and some, you know, even substantive errors in the written examination. And she helped us correct and improve the written examination.
So possibly, sir, during your time, maybe that was the least number of PTCs that were granted.
In history, yes.
In history. 600
Marami
PTCs.
Ako nakaaway. Maraming sumamalo, especially congressmen and senators.
But that was 600 for how many years, sir?
From 1999 up to January of 2001, when then-president era, 14 months.
14 months, 600 lang. All right, this leads us to this problem now, sir. Atimonan, crimes on the street, the mayor of Makunakon, Isabella, also killed in Quezon City. You've been batting for a gun control. Actually, you know, there's a longer term for that, but just to understand it briefly, it's gun control over at the Senate. And Senator Gringo Hanasan is saying they're actually looking at using your bill almost in its entirety because I guess it's a good bill, sir.
That's Senate Bill 2933.
Okay.
The gunless society or the gunless advocates, including the gun advocates, no? They're one is saying that they are supporting Senate Bill 2993. No?
What is in this for both parties to support your bill?
Well, the main feature or features of the bill is that instead of issuing a license to the firearm, the license will be issued to a person, and the firearm or firearms possessed by the person will be issued registration. The firearms will be registered under the licensed person.
Wow. Okay. That's educational for me because normally, my understanding, sir, if you get a licensed gun, that's it.
Yes.
Lisensya ang baril ko, okay na to. Nasa pangalan ko, tapos na usapan.
Tapos na. And a person may possess as many firearms as he can, ano? But he has so many licenses for those firearms and so many permits to carry for the firearms. So instead of resorting to that, mas maganda na yung tao na yung bigyan ng lisensya to possess, and then lahat ng firearms that he possesses, i-re-register na lang under his name. Mm-hmm. Another feature of the bill is that a vault must be will be a requirement. No? Dapat may vault sa loob ng bahay.
Okay,
para sa safety, ano ito? Kasi right. Siyempre yung mga bata sa loob ng bahay. And the licensed person will be answerable, will be responsible pagka na-misuse yung firearms or nagamit sa aksidente.
Responsibilidad niya.
Responsibilidad. Yun. Kaya dapat may vault.
But I'm sorry for this, sir. How many license can a person have? Just one?
Depende. Kasi pati yung mga tao na pupwedeng mag-possess o mabigyan ng lisensya, limitado lang. Unahin ko na, media practitioners. Ano? And then, of course, members of the bar. And so, marami mga qualified.
Ibig ko sabihin, sir, an individual only has one license.
Isang license lang. But he can possess
many
registered firearms.
Okay.
Pwedeng lima, pwedeng sampu, pwedeng labing lima.
And what's the basis for that, sir? Di ba yun din ang problema?
They're gun enthusiasts, but they cannot bring... That's not in my proposal, but I intend to amend even in the substitute bill later on, pagka ito pinasa na or naikot na sa floor, sana wag na mag-issue ng permit to carry. Ang payagan na lang na merong mag-possess ng firearm, mag-carry ng firearm outside residence, mga uniformed police personnel, saka yung military personnel, and members of the law enforcement agencies in uniform. And on duty, you know.
So, in other words, sir, that kind of permit to carry, if that is put in place, hindi na po kailangan ng COMELEC gun ban.
Hindi na kailangan.
Hindi na kailangan yun.
Yes.
Yeah, hindi na sila mamang problema doon.
Ang gusto ko i-reverse yung culture or yung perception na pag may nakita nga tayo meron na kausbong sa baywang, hindi na natin pinapansin eh. Maski hold upper na pala ng bangko o kaya kidnapper, sabihin na natin, hindi, may permit to carry yan o kaya police yan. But kung alam ng mga tao na pag nakakita sila ng mayroong baril at naka-civilian, agad-agad, they can call the nearest police station and report that person. Mm-hmm. So eventually, or in the long run, pag na-educate na yung mga tao, yung publiko, eventually, mababawasan talaga yung crime kasi pagdadala pa lang ng baril, suspect na. Kasi ang assumption, you're a bad element.
Okay. To get a license and to get a gun registered, what is the renewal period for this, sir?
2 years, actually.
But when you renew, sir, is it in your proposal na you have to go through the whole requirements again?
Hindi na, i-renew mo lang kasi pumasa ka na doon sa mga requirements.
Paano naman pag medyo naging, twisted
lumuwag,
na yun?
Pag lumuwag yung tornilyo.
Maybe, because it's such a responsibility, sir, to really, carry a gun. I mean, hold a gun, have a gun.
Pero kung may depresya ang utak, in the first place, hindi siya papasa sa psychiatric examination. But you're correct, maybe a regular or a periodic re-examination of the applicant or the possessor of the license should be done.
Because it shouldn't be that easy, sir. I mean, it must be difficult to get a license and to get your gun or guns registered. Pero once you get it, sir, hindi naman ata fair na, okay, renewal, para nagpapare-renew lang ako ng kotse.
Alam mo, Pinky, what struck me, there was a news article sa inyo ko yata na panood yun, when I was not yet chief PNP, na mayroong bulag who was issued a permit,
that's right, sir.
A license, and a permit to carry firearm outside residence. Mayroong PTC, a bulag. Paano yun? Ibig sabihin nun, fixer yung kausap niya, hindi naman siya nagpunta ng krame, hindi siya nag-gun safety seminar, siguro under the guava tree, inside Camp Crame, doon na lang nag-negotiate kung sino yung inutusan niya, nagbayad ng kung magkano sa fixer at nakakuha siya ng license at nakakuha ng permit to carry.
Which leads me to my next question, yeah, sir.
And it stuck in my mind. Kasi sabi ko, pag nag-chief PNP ako, halimbawa...
Yun yung ginamit mo, di ba? Sabi mo, in your term, that will never happen again.
Yes, because personal yung appearance talaga nila doon.
Yeah.
And so, I made it a one-stop shop, ano? Kasi two-pronged yung approach ko eh. To stop corruption altogether in the application.
Yeah, yeah.
Kasi nangyayari noon nga, puro pictures yung kausap. So ang ginawa ko, nireconfigure namin yung office doon sa Firearms and Explosives Office or Division at the time in such a way na yung last counter, yung last window, land bank. So doon ka magbabayad ng license fee.
Talaga?
Well,
okay.
Talagang iikot ka lang ng ganun, kumpleto na yung requirements mo, and then pagdating mo ng land bank, bayad ka, makukuha mo yung yung license
tapos
mo.
Tapos sir, yung magbabayad, siya mismo yung makakakuha ng permit.
Ng resibo.
I-personal, ano?
Yes, personal.
Kailangan magbayad ka personally.
At saka pipirma siya.
That's where I wanted to go, sir. Kasi kahit na, you know, even let's say this is a good law, a good bill that can be turned into law, sir, the fear really is yung mga fixers sa loob. I mean, so what, yeah, sir, kung ang ganda naman ng intention mo dun sa batas, pero hindi naman, marami namang manluloko.
And mind you, nawala talaga yung fixers during my time. I'm not saying that there are fixers now, ano? Pero I can only speak na during my time, talagang zero yung fixer noon.
So nag one-stop shop ka during your term. After your term, natanggal po yun?
Hindi ko alam. I asked the head of the Firearms and Explosives Office during the hearing dito sa aming mga bills sa gun control. Sabi niya, it's still a one-stop shop.
Ah, it's still there?
Sabi niya.
Okay, I wonder how effective it is right now. Sir, I wanted to ask you this too. You issued permit to carries during your time as PNP chief. Is that the same practice now? Or is it just the head of Firearms and Explosives Division?
Chief PNP pa rin. Pero yung requirements, pareho pa rin. Now, whether or not nako-comply do sa mga requirements, that I do not know. But during my time, only one person was exempted. Isa lang yung na-exempt ko nun eh.
Who is?
He happened to be the President of the Republic of the Philippines. You know, there was a funny incident. I was in Malacanang, and President Erab at the time was showing me a brand new titanium caliber 38 revolver. Sabi niya, bigay it sa akin ng Secret Service, pwede pa itong mapalisensyahan. Sabi ko, pwede naman, sir. Kailan bang pumunta ako ng Grame? Sabi ko, hindi na siguro, sir, Commander-in-Chief. So I called up, I think at the time, General De Leon. Uh-huh. Sabi ko, will you jot down, do you have a
sinong De Leon to, sir? General?
Ricardo.
Okay.
Because he was the head of CSG at that time. Yun yung under-functional grouping niya yung firearms. Ano? Sabi ko, pakijot down ito. Brand, caliber 38, serial number. Sabi ko, isyon mo ng lisensya, isyon mo rin ng permit to carry. So he could not believe what he heard because alam niya kung gaano kami ka-stricto. Ang sabi niya, sir, sabi ko, hindi pa ako tapos. Isulat mo yung pangalan. Joseph Ejercito Estrada, number 1 Fox Street. Ah, yes sir, sabi niya. So in the afternoon, nakuha ni President Erap. He was the only person exempted from all the requirements because he happened to be the president.
Commander-in-chief also. So, sir, if, let's say, for example, this could be passed into law, you know, your job ends there, like in any other, you know, you're a lawmaking body, but the implementation will still be up to the police in the end.
Yeah, the implementation.
Okay, so that's where probably makikita natin how effective that will be because you can have a good law. If you don't have implementers following it to the letter, it becomes a useless law.
But as long as the law is clear, ano, yung statute masyado malinaw, wala na masyadong discretion. Ang problema sa karamihan ng batas, because, di ba, mga lawyers nga yung gumagawa, karamihan, medyo may vagueness ng konti para may trabaho yung abogado.
They can skirt around the issue.
Yes. Sir,